What's going on? Why aren't you guys at school?
School's cancelled. Everyone's gone Wonka crazy.
A new shipment of fresh candy shopping on you first. Goodbye, come on!
That's okay. You guys go on without me.
Fully automated. Toothpaste cap twisting is the only profession I know. But I guess you don't need cap twisters when you've got robot gizmos.
Don't worry about it, Dad. You never liked that whole job anyway. Maybe now you can get back into the candy business. Like Grandpa Joe keeps saying.
Grandpa Joe likes to dream big dreams, Charlie, but I'm afraid big dreams aren't gonna put food on the table. I don't know how I'm gonna tell your mom, Charlie. Things were hot enough when I had a job, but now...
I said don't worry about it, Dad. Just think positive.
Positive? Why?
Why not?
You've nothing to lose, so why not choose to think positive? Whenever my luck is on the blink, I think positive. Whenever I'm feeling down and out, and don't know what to do,
your time to count the cost. Cause thinking positive, that comes free.
Right,
positive is the way to be. Whenever I'm teetering on the brink, I think positive. The moment I do, I'm in the pink, thinking positive. Remember this song, when things go wrong, then you'll know what to do.
Charlie, I haven't had this much fun since the factory manager got his tongue stuck in the conveyor belt. Now let's head home. I'm positive we're having something special for supper tonight.
Leftover cabbage soup?
No, fresh cabbage soup.
Now that's positive.
Remember this song when things go wrong. Then you'll know what to do. In no time you'll be thinking positive.
From morning till night with a very horrible grumbling in their tummies. I'm afraid young Charlie felt it worst of all. But once each year, Charlie got a very special treat.
Surprise! Happy birthday, Charlie!
Oh, surprise! Happy birthday, Charlie!
I've already said that.
We did? When?
Give me some present.
Oh, yes, very pleasant.
Present.
Present.
Present!
Here you go, my love.
It's from all of us.
Go on, Charlie, open it up.
It's a Wonka whistle, Scrooge's foot mellow delight.
of them all. Real ripple, carefully processed at 2700 RPMs for precisely 60.2 seconds.
Please! Our fault! We agreed to get the Nutterific.
The fudge mallow's the best, and you know it.
Nutterific.
Fudge mallow.
Nutterific, Nutterific, Nutterific.
Oh, and I think he's terrific too. Happy birthday, Charlie.
Mom, Dad, it's Charlie's day.
Go on, Charlie, open it up.
Then, Charlie, open it for goodness sakes.
Now, don't be too disappointed, my darling, if you don't find what you're looking for.
The thing to remember is no matter what happens, you still have the bar of candy.
Right. Go ahead, think positive, and open it up.
But I thought we were going to give him a bar of candy.
That's what I said. Bar of candy.
Oh, well, sure, I'd love a jar, Brandy.
She said he still had a bar of candy.
Who's got a bar of candy?
Charlie!
Well, why didn't you just say so?
Go on, Charlie, open it.
Yeah, Charlie, open it up. Who knows? Maybe our luck has finally changed.
Okay, here goes.
Go on, Charlie, open it.
Yeah, please open it. You're making me so jumpy.
Oh, you're always grumpy. That woman was born grumpy, but I love her all the same. Oi, Charlie, open the bar and see if you've won.
Well, that's that. Who wants a piece?
Oh, we wouldn't dream of it, Charlie.
Come on, Dad, have a piece. You deserve something after losing your job.
What? What? It's not true, Charlie. That's not funny. Tell me it's not true.
We'll starve.
It is true, and we will not starve. Now, what kind of party is this anyway? Come on, let's splurge a little. Put on the radio.
Mr. Bucket's right. What's a little more electricity? Charlie, plug in the radio.
Really? This is the best birthday ever.
We interrupt this broadcast to bring you breaking news coverage. In the past hour, a third gold digger has been found in Snellville, Georgia. And what is your name, young lady?
Violet. Violet Beauregard.
Violet, quit chewing your gum so loudly. It's not ladylike. It's not ladylike at all.
How can it, Ma? You flap your jaws even more than I do.
Now, Violet, I do not appreciate that sort of language. Your words. Ask me nicely.
No prob. Hey, Ma, would you please can it? I'm being interviewed here.
So, Violet, how did you find your golden ticket?
Normally, I'm a gum chewer. In fact, I adore gum. Love it, love it, love it. I chew gum all day long, except for when I'm eating. Then I take it out of my mouth and put it behind my ear like this.
Isn't that clever? She's so clever. She thought of that herself.
Cool it, Ma. And when I'm sleeping, I put it on the headboard. So in the morning, all I have to do is pop it back in and start chewing again.
She thought of that, too. So clever.
Sometimes it's a little hard to get started. And one time, it got caught in my hair. But Ma cut it out, and I just went right on chewing it. It was a hairy moment, though.
She just left.
Very witty, Violet. Now tell me about the golden ticket.
Hey, keep your pants on, Phineas. I'm getting to it. So, like I said, I'm a gum chewer normally, but when I heard about Wonka's contest, I laid off the gums, which were right on the candy bars. Of course, I'm right back on the gum now. In fact, I've been working on this piece for over 3 months straight. I've beaten the record set by my best friend, Cornelia Prince Medal. Hi, Cornelia. Listen to this. Hear that? Listen some more. That's the sound of you losing. Chew on that, Princess Prince Medal.
The Wonka bar sales are up to over 200,000 an hour, and but this just in, the fourth gold digger has also been found in Television City, California. Leaving only the fifth and final golden ticket to be found, I'm live in the home of Mike TV, the lucky winner of golden ticket number 4. Here's Mrs. TV now. Tell me about finding that golden ticket, ma'am.
Well, Phineas, Mike and I were...
Did I tell you never to interrupt? This is the best part. Crack, smack, whack, dead. Did you see that guy die? That was so totally awesome.
So we gather, Mike. Now, Mrs. TV, about that.
Wait a minute. Talk to me. Oh, hold on. Talk to me.
Well, Mike, would you mind telling us how it feels?
Dude, can't you see I'm busy running an empire here? Gotta go catch you later. Okay, Oprah, what do you want?
Well, Mike, I'd like to tell the folks at home just
hold the phone, dude. Check it out. I love the show. Wait, you play Wii? I'm the best dude, the best.
Mike has certain focus issues.
So I gather. Now, Mike, how did you get your golden ticket?
Yeah, okay. I guess I got the big shiny ticket. Big deal. Means giving up half a day of all my favorite shows to tour some stupid chocolate factory, which probably has karate cell reception. Forgive me, Oprah baby. Gotta change the channel. Hey, dude, check her out.
So what school does our latest golden ticket winner attend?
School? Are you joking or just crazy? Who needs school? I got the net, TV, and my Game Boy, fool. Some kids like electric trains, and some kids like to use their brains to earn a university degree. I won't share their thirst for knowledge. I don't need to go to college. Me, I see it all on TV.
Some kids like to sing and dance, and some kids go to Paris, France, while others visit Washington, D.C.
I don't learn a single thing, cause I can download anything. It's all on my computer for free.
Some kids go to baseball games, and other kids have nicknames like 10 days at a Boy Scout Jamboree.
While Whippy kids read books of verse, I play Destroy the Universe. No one has Nintendo games like me.
Some kids like to fly balloons or play the latest others like to surf in Waikiki.
I can visit London Road
and Tokyo without leaving home.
Take a spaceship to the moon
and back on any afternoon.
Yes, we can do it all from A to Z. My computer and my Cowboys even cuter.
Maybe we could eat it.
That's quite enough. Now we should all just go to bed.
Can Grandpa Joe just tell me one Wonka story before bed? Just one, please?
All right. Just one. And no zombie worker stories. You can just sleep.
Hey, do you guys care if Pa tells Charlie a bedtime? Yes, not. I hope he cleaned up his body.
So, Charlie. I got a story for you.
What's it about? Pirates? A giant peach? Zombies?
Now, I promised your mum I wouldn't tell you any zombie stories. Now, this one's about a little boy who just so happens to be celebrating his birthday.
Yeah?
And he thought he had opened up all of his presents, but guess what? There's one more that he hadn't got yet. Here, Charlie. Nice job.
It's a Wonka Nutty Crumb surprise!
Shh!
But how'd you get it?
Well, I still have my ways. Now, remember, Charlie, there's still a teeny tiny million to one chance that this here bar could be hiding
the fifth and last golden ticket.
What's going on over there?
What's that in your hands?
Well, it's just a little something from me to Charlie on his birthday. Now, shh, keep it quiet. I don't want to wake the others.
What's going on?
I smell chocolate.
What are you up to, Joe?
Just something from me to the boy. Go ahead, Charlie, open it.
Grandma Joe, I'm too nervous. You open it.
No, I'll tell you what, Charlie. Let's open it together, eh? A lifetime supply of chocolate. Ready? One, two, three.
Nothing.
It's a good thing, really. Chocolate's very bad, Nate.
Well, that's true. I mean, a lifetime supply of chocolate, why, you'd be the size of Big Ben. Parliament!
Wonka.
Cheer up, Charlie. Give me a smile. What happened to that smile I used to know? Don't you know your grin has always been my sunshine? Let that sunshine show.
Come, Charlie.
Their hunger at bay for one more long, cold day as winter tightened its grip. Poor Mr. Bucket searched for odd jobs like shoveling snow, and little Charlie began the long upward trek to school.
Charlie, where's your coat?
I don't got a coat.
Here, take my scarf. You'll freeze to death.
Thanks. You making rounds?
I was hoping to, Charlie, but it's too cold. Just trying to get back to the shop before the candy freezes. Help me pack up, would you?
Sure.
Oh, blast it! My fingers are so cold I can't feel them. Say, Charlie, grab that box of nut crunchies for me, would you? Don't want them to freeze.
Okay. Look there in the snow. A silver coin. 50 pence! I think you must have dropped this.
Wow, 50 pence! No, it's not mine. Why don't you just take it home to your folks?
You think I should? Maybe I should put up a notice board.
That coin's probably been buried in the snow for weeks. Take it, Charlie. You know what? Take this for being such a good kid.
Really?
Really. You look like you're starving.
It's so good. Thanks, I'd better get to school. You think I could have just one more?
Yeah,
and
why not?
This time I'll pay for it.
I'd give you no one for free, but the boss is pretty strict about inventory. What'll it be, Charlie, my boy?
Well, this one I'd like to share with my family. Grandpa Joe likes the Whipple Scrumptious Fudge Mallard Delight, but Grandma Josephine likes the Nutterific.
Well, then you should get the Whipple Scrumptious Nutterific Totally Twisted Combo Pot. Just out. Look, I know you're going to share it all, but you might as well take a little taste, you know, just to make sure you like it too.
Charlie, you help me out of this bed, and I'll race you to the factory, eh?